Elon Musk announced on the X platform that Tesla will officially launch Robotaxi, which is driveless taxi, on August 8th this year. This has stirred up excitement among many people because it signifies a new stage for Tesla's self-driving technology. Hello, and welcome to the Curiosity Club. Today, let's talk about Elon Musk's vision of Robotaxi. As early as 2016, when Musk announced Tesla's mass plan part 2, he mentioned the need to achieve true full self-driving FSD capability on an autopilot, which is a starting point for Robotaxi. Once Tesla successfully achieves FSD, Musk's vision is for Tesla's fleet and vehicles owned by individuals to form a large Tesla shared fleet, also known as Robotaxi's business model. Musk refers to this as a combination of Uber and Airbnb. When true self-driving is achieved and allowed on the roads, Tesla owners can choose to rent out their idle vehicles to join Tesla's taxi fleet, earning income by providing passenger services. In recent company earnings reports, Tesla has unveiled some UI designs for ride-hailing apps, including temperature settings, riding hailings, and summoning features. However, compared to other riding hailing services, there are currently no significant differences. Currently, Tesla's available self-driving service is called Supervised for Self-Driving. As the words mentioned, this requires occasional supervision and human intervention when necessary, meaning there still needs to be a driver in the driver's seat. However, the next step for Robotaxi is to achieve true self-driving, which likely means no steering wheels or driver's seat. Now there's a fairly unanimous speculation about this year to be unveiled model, which is based on a lot of information that Elon Musk himself has shared in the media. Firstly, it's quite evident that since there won't be a need for a human driver, the vehicle won't have features like a steering wheel and pedals. Additionally, considering that taxis are primarily used for short-distance trips in urban areas, it's unlikely to have large-capacity batteries for long-range driving. Features focused on personal driving comfort and handling, typically found in private cars, will likely be removed. For instance, adjustable seats may not be available, and seats might be fixed or mechanically adjustable. Furthermore, Robotaxi may not have a rear seat, instead opting for two rows of inward-facing seats. This design facilitates better communication among passengers. Moreover, windows may be larger to provide passengers with a better view of the outside environment, and large sliding doors will make it easier for passengers to get in and out. All these changes are expected to reduce the cost of Robotaxi compared to conventional private electric vehicles. Last year, there was an early design sketch of Robotaxi that surfaced on the X platform. The sketch was from the latest Musk biography, mentioning that the third generation of Tesla cars will cost $25,000. Now, this design sketch, well, it kind of looks like a tricycle, to be honest. However, Musk has mentioned on numerous occasions, both internally and externally, that Robotaxi will have a futuristic design. It doesn't want to be just a transitional product. He hopes that this robot vehicle will be the demonstration of fully autonomous capabilities for the future. Therefore, many speculate that the upcoming Robotaxi is likely to be similar to the Cybertruck. Regardless, we'll have to wait until August 8th for the unveiling. However, even if Robotaxi is launched on schedule, it doesn't mean Tesla's ride-hailing service will hit the road soon. Aside from needing government approval for self-driving vehicles to operate on the roads, various laws and regulations are not yet fully developed. Furthermore, basic infrastructure such as maintenance, charging, or depots for self-driving vehicles is still in progress. In April, with no prior announcement, Musk suddenly visited China with the main purpose of implementing Tesla's FSD technology in mainland China. The Chinese government is likely to support testing Robotaxi in some areas. Due to the complex traffic conditions in China, where pedestrians, bicycles, and electric scooters mix together, driving data in such scenarios is more effective for improving FSD training algorithms. Additionally, Tesla recently purchased 10,000 Nvidia H100 high-performance computing chips for self-driving training. As of now, Tesla is likely the second largest holder of Nvidia H100 GPUs, second only to Meta, Facebook's parent company. This shows Musk's dedication to launch Robotaxi to some extent. It's worth mentioning that Tesla is not the only participant in the self-driving taxi race. Notable competitors include General Motors Cruise and Amazon's Zoox, both of which have started road tests in North America. However, Tesla's potential application in the Chinese market shows its ambition. Given Tesla's rapid pace of technological advancement, evidenced by the development of humanoid robot Optimus, we can be hopeful for Tesla's Robotaxi. Okay, that's it for today. See you next time.